कॉन्सीरीज प्रेजेंट्स डॉटनेट इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, व्हाट इज डॉटनेट। बिफोर वी कंटिन्यू प्लीज सब्सक्राइब फॉर अपडेट्स बाय क्लिकिंग द बटन हियर। दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर यू एज अ डॉटनेट डेवलपर टू नो द हिस्ट्री एंड द एवोल्यूशन ऑफ डॉटनेट फ्रेमवर्क। हियर इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट is there before .NET framework and what are the problems we face in that and how we overcome all those problems in .NET framework. Before .NET framework, COM is there. So let us discuss what is COM and what problems we are facing in COM. COM stands for Component Object Model. The COM is one of the Microsoft technologies. Using this technology, we can develop Windows application as well as web applications. In earlier COM, VB is a programming language which is used to implement web application, and ASP.NET is used to implement web applications. Disadvantages of .NET or of COM are as follows. Incomplete object-oriented programming means it will not support all the features of the OOPs. Platform dependent, since COM applications can run only on Windows OS. To overcome the above problem, the .NET framework comes into the picture. So what is the .NET represents? NET stands for Network Enabled Technologies, and in .NET, dot refers to the object oriented and net refers to the internet. So the complete .NET means object oriented, with we can implement internet based applications. So what is a framework? A framework is a software, or you can say a framework is a collection of many small technologies integrated together to develop applications that can be executed anywhere. What does the .NET framework provide? .NET framework provide two things as follows: BCL and CLR. BCL, base class library, is designed by Microsoft. Without BCL, we cannot write any code in .NET. So BCL is known as building blocks of .NET programs. These can install into the machine. When we install the .NET framework, BCL contains predefined classes, and these classes are used for the purpose of application development. Physical location of BCL is C, Windows Assembly. CLR stands for Common Language Runtime. It is the core component used in the .NET framework. It is responsible for converting MSIL, which is also called as Microsoft Intermediate Language Code, inactive into native code and then execution. .NET framework is compiled twice. In the first compiler, the source code is compiled by respective language compiler and generates intermediate code, which is known as MSIL and IL, Intermediate Language Code or managed code. The second compiler, MSIL, is converted into native code. Native code means code specific to the operating system, so that the code is executed by operating systems using CLR. Using the first compiler is slow. Always the first compiler is slow and second compiler is fast. Is another component which we use in .NET, which is called as JIT, which is stands for Justin Compiler. It is a component of CLR which is responsible for converting an MSIL into native code. The native code is directly readable by the operating systems. .NET framework has different types of flavors. .NET framework, the general version, runs in .NET application on OS only. .NET Mono framework, it runs on Unix, Linux and Mac, etc. There is also a .NET Core framework which runs on all of the devices. .NET Compact framework runs for mobile and smartphones. MSIL is only CPU dependent and will run only on Windows OS using .NET framework, because .NET framework is designed for Windows OS only. There is another company named Novell designed separate framework known as Mono framework. Using this framework, we can run MSIL on different OS like Linux, Unix, Mac, and so on. .NET framework is dependent on platforms mostly, but the upcoming platforms are trying to be independent. So what is not a .NET? .NET is not an operating system or an application or a database or ERP or a testing tool. So what exactly is a .NET framework means? It supports many languages and many technologies. .NET supports 60 plus languages which are not created by Microsoft. Some of these languages are VB.NET, C#, J Sharp, F Sharp, JavaScript, Python, Ruby, and so on. And the technologies that are ASP.NET, AWO.NET, WCF, WBF, WWF, Ajax, Linux, so on. What a language is and its needs. Language acts as a mediator between the programmer and the system. It offers some rules and regulations for writing the program. The language also offers some libraries which are required for writing the program. What are the technologies and what are their needs? Technologies are designed for a particular purpose. For example, developing a web-related application, we need ASP.NET technology. But the technology does not offer any specific rules for writing a program. This is why technologies cannot be implemented individually. VB.NET and C# both are programming languages. Using these two languages, we can implement Windows and desktops and also .NET applications, ASP.NET applications. We need to use the languages inside the technologies so we can create an entire applications. Every language has its own compiler, .NET frameworks and their extensions. We will discuss more about these compilers and CLRs so on in our upcoming videos. Thanks for watching our videos. Visit us on our website www.conseries.org, and for more C# interviews and Angular interviews, please click here and subscribe now so that you can get updated videos from our channel on your websites. Thank you.